Good morning, motherfuckers.
Freeze your body for $200,000, or if you're looking to save a few bucks, just your head for $80,000. There are also annual costs, but don't worry, they offer student discounts. Well, that's our show. Thanks so much for watching. Your homework for next week is to stick your head in a freezer and see if you're in prior preservation.
I turn on.
Time yourself. Let us know how long you last in the comments.
YouTube. You need to go get me coffee. I didn't know that was a fucking ad. It was a fucking ad. Jesus Christ.
Paul Ryan's out there defending the healthcare proposal.
Then I turn on the news, watch Little Young Turks. I can't stand Cenk Uygur. He's a pretentious dickhead.
The Senate has their own version, and that's
right, I don't want to hear his opinion and his rumbling and bitching about what the fuck's going on. I just want a motherfucker to tell me what's going on. I don't want your fucking opinion, bitch ass nigga.
Proposal, so he's going to get asked about that. I'm curious to see what his answer is going to be. Let's watch.
Brief look shows that over the course of a 10-year period, you're going to save $321 billion off the deficit. However, $22 million will be without coverage. What they're basically saying to the Congressional Budget Office is if you're not going to force people to buy Obamacare, if you're not going to force people to buy something they don't want, then they won't buy it. So it's not that people are getting pushed off a plan, it's that people will choose.
See, this dude's a difference between
not to buy something.
You ever heard a white person say, well, there's a difference between black people and niggers? Okay, fair enough. This is the difference between a white man and a fucking cracker. A straight fucking cracker.
Many people won't do it.
There you go. That's one. That's one right there.
Parts of that are misleading, and parts of that are flat out lies. So let me explain.
I don't think there's anything wrong with white people, but I think all crackers should die. Yeah, one of my neighbors just, you know, that shit. He was like, yeah, man, I don't know. He has a black girlfriend. See, that's how fucking warped white motherfuckers' heads are. This dude's got a white motherfucker or a black girlfriend and shit, says this shit. I think it's hilarious, though. I mean, yes, coffee with the cream and the sugar is gonna kill ya. You know it. So, it'll be the long pour. It's called a long pour if you didn't know. And this is what I look like in the morning. I haven't even looked in the mirror. I don't give a fuck. It's late night. I've been sleepy. I've been very tired lately. I don't know if it, maybe I need health care. I don't know.
But, you know, see. Sometimes when I go look and see, look how fucking fantastic that is.
Which dictates what I'm gonna do. Ah, it's a beautiful day.
0.5 on air, 104star.com on your smartphone.
What the hell is that? TNT. TNT, nigga, who is you? Ain't life grand?
I could. Expensive that they couldn't possibly afford it. And then finally, there's higher
costs and lifetime
caps.
I could be
that you're also getting less
doing something else.
Well, for most
of what? I don't know.
So once you don't want to buy that,
I don't have a fucking clue. This is the fucking country we live in now.
Yo, see, I told you they didn't want health care insurance in the first place.
Find your own way. Figure it out. Pick yourself up by the bootstraps.
And the press does not hold the Republicans to account nearly as much as it should.
I don't know.
Paul Ryan and the rest of the Republicans consistently.
It was Obama. It's a double standard.
So what he said right there was a knowing
difference between a black person and a nigger.
The whole country, and he's the head of the Republicans' policy proposal.
Is the difference between a white man and a cracker.
Lifetime views. You know who did that? You did that. We're now larger.
Don't
than
fall for that shit.
ABC, you name a news network online, we're larger than
that. Any white man that says
and
that shit
all that
is justifying for all the times he said nigger.
And here we are, guys.
Real shit.
Build independent media together with us.
I don't believe these motherfuckers. It's impossible. I've been lied to too many fucking times. Real shit. Real fucking shit. You got one of the biggest liars in the fucking world is the president. white man. Black man could never done what he did. White man could have can pull cons like that. Black man can't do that shit. Let's be real. He wouldn't have made it to the fucking primaries with that shit. With that lying bullshit. That lying fucking bullshit. Real fucking shit. That you can keep your health care and fucking shit lies. That was, I mean, when it has to do with corporate interest, dude, corporations control health care, not fucking the government. So, blame your grandfather's creations, not fucking him. Get fucking real. Know where the problem is. As a matter of fact, the problem is in Washington, but it's not. It's in fucking Wall Street. It's in Wall Street. The financial sector, the insurance sector, these are the motherfuckers that are destroying shit. That's who you need to be yelling at. These stuffy, short dick, impotent fucking white men that own that shit. Niggas don't own none of that shit. None of it. None. So go holler at them. Because they don't give a fuck about none of us. Paul Ryan, those kinds of motherfuckers and shit, in the pockets of motherfuckers. They need to be dealt with. That nigga needs to go to a softball game. Real shit. Paul Ryan needs to go play softball more often. Real shit.
Just an absolute tyrant from a lot of people.
I can't stand this bitch either.
But news outlets that bitch is,
this bitch is
day after day.
The fucking
cite unnamed sources, use stories without
that's a
sources.
Devil. Not even in disguise.
You mentioned the Taramucci story where they had to have reporters resign.
Oh, horse mouth bitch. Huckabee. Fucking Huckabee. Fuck all the Huckabees, nigga. They need to go play softball. Exactly. Exactly. Well, this is what I'm going to be doing all day. Pretty much. It's a fucked up week. People keep dying and shit and having things happen to them. And I'm just sick of thinking about death. I don't participate in that shit. I don't know. Because to me, none of my motherfuckers ever really leave. There's always a piece of them with. My dude Norman, he's gone, but he's not gone. He's not gone. Because I'm still here. There's movement still going on. He was a part of that shit. He helped tremendously. He helped me a lot. I wouldn't... All this internet shit and fucking networking and finding information and knowing where to go. Straight up. When I'm gone, I'm still going to be here. This movement's still going to be here. I don't give a fuck. It's getting too... It's already got momentum. It's... I ain't got to push the cart no more. I can let it go. It's... Woo! So... Fuck the government.